गुड आफ्टरनून गुड
आफ्टरनून
गुड आफ्टरनून गुड आफ्टरनून विल यू कंप्लीट दैट टेबल?
यस मैम।
11 11 क्यूब टू 20 क्यूब।
यस मैम।
ओके जेफ रीड द वैल्यूज। जेफ व्हाट इज 11 क्यूब? जेफ आग्ना रीड द वैल्यूज।
11 cube equal to 1331. 12 cube equal to 1728. 13 cube equal to 2197. 14 cube equal to 2744.
Jeff, read the rest. Jeff, 15 cube. Jeff. Asan.
Yes, ma'am.
Read.
15 is equal to 3375.
16 cube.
16 cube is equal to 4096. 17 cube is equal to 4913. 18 cube is equal to 5832. 19 cube is equal to 6859. 20 cube is equal to 80,000.
8,000. Okay. Now we have studied how to find a given number is a perfect cube or not. What we will do? First of all, we need to prime factorize the given numbers, write all the factors, then group the factors into groups of three. Group them into a groups of three. If we can group all the factors into groups of three, we can say that it is a perfect cube. Otherwise, not. Next, we are going to do what? If it is not a perfect cube, by which number we need to multiply to get a perfect cube? Okay, that type of questions we are going to do. Okay, now write the first question is 243 a perfect cube? Is 243 a perfect cube? Is 243 a perfect cube? If not, find the smallest number. If not, find the smallest number by which 243 should be multiplied. 243 must be multiplied. To get a perfect cube. So number is 243. First of all, prime factor is 243. All of you try to prime factor is 243. Three. 243 equal to 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Is it a perfect cube? No. This we can group into a group of numbers. Three can be grouped into a group of three. And the second set, we need one more three. Okay. So 243 is not a cube. Not a cube. Now, by which number we need to multiply to get a cube? What we need? We need here one more. What we need? Three. If one more, if one more three is there, it will be a perfect cube. So we should multiply this 243 by 3. Okay, so that we will get a perfect cube. So multiply 243 by 3, we get a perfect cube. Multiply 243 by a 3, because if one more, how much?
729,
which is a perfect cube, right? Which is a perfect cube, 729, which is a perfect cube. So we can multiply 243 by 3. So that the product is 729.
Well, you should do this in every problems.
Yes. All the problems the same way. Okay. Second question, this type of questions we will do. Find the smallest number. Find the smallest number by which the following numbers, must be multiplied to get a first question. First number is 256. Start doing 256. First of all, prime factor is 256. Find the factors of 256. 256. Two into 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 two. Group them. Can be a group. This also can be a group. Here we need one more two. This 256 is not a perfect cube. What is the next step? What can we say?
Two fifty six into three is a perfect. Two. We need three here. One more two. We need three is for the last problem. Here we need a two.
So multiply 256 by two.
That is 512.
Which is a perfect cube. So what is you have to find out which set is not filled. Here, two set of twos are the triplets. Two set of triplets, two into two into two. Two sets are there. But in the third set, we need one more two for completing a perfect cube. Okay, so by that two, we need to multiply the given number. So 256 into two, that is 512, which is a perfect cube. Is that clear, all of you? Agna, Nikila, Anugrah, Vinayak, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So do I will give you one question, same type of question. The number is 72. Find the smallest number by which we need to multiply to get a perfect cube. 72 2 36 2 18 2 9 3, correct?
No.
So 72 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into, oh no, only 1, 2 threes. So 2s are in triplets.
Ma'am, low sound.
Low sound. Others? Can you hear me properly?
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Here we have 1 threes needed, isn't it? So 72 is not a perfect cube. 72 is not a perfect cube. So we should multiply 72 by which number?
3.
Now to multiply it by 3. That is 72 into 3 is
216,
which is a perfect cube. Which is a perfect cube. Now you have some homework questions. First set of questions. Which of the following are perfect cube? Which of the following are perfect cube? You just find whether they are perfect cube or not. Only that. Okay. Numbers are 16 numbers, last 0. You just find the prime factors of these numbers and check whether they can be appear as triplets, that is a group of threes. Okay. Find out whether they are, if they are appearing as a group of the prime factors appears as a group of triplets, you can say it is a perfect cube, otherwise not. Now next set of question, find the smallest number.
Ma'am, this is also homework.
Yes. Find the smallest numbers by which the following must be multiplied. Following must be multiplied to get a perfect cube. Question, first number. First number, 675. Second one, 100. Third one, 392. Okay, all of you copied?
No,
okay,
no, Ma'am, no. Can you show it?
Sure.
Ma'am. Ma'am, when is the submission of the assignment?
The next day. Only 2 pages, no. Simple, only half an hour.
Ma'am, it's assignment.
Last period, I have given an assignment, that one. Okay, children. So we have studied how to find a number or how to make a given number into a by which number we need to multiply to get a perfect cube from a number which is not a perfect cube. From that, we can get a perfect cube by multiplying some number. Okay. Next set of questions are, by which number we should divide to get a perfect cube? The given number may not be a perfect cube. The given number may not be a perfect cube. So what we will do, we will divide it by some number so that the quotient will be a perfect cube. So instead of multiplying, in this set of questions, we are dividing by a given, by a number to get a perfect cube, okay? So write the question, find the smallest number by which, third set of questions, find the smallest number by which the following numbers must be divided to get a perfect cube. Shall we start? First question. We will go as 81. First one, 81. First of all, prime factor is this 81. Prime factor is 81. We will get 3, 27, again 3, 9, 3.
Ma'am, last 2 questions are homework.
Yes. So 81 can, the factors are 3 into 3. Now we have one triplet. So we need how many more? If it is multiplication, we need 2 more 3s. Okay. But here we need division. By which number we need to divide? So what we can remove what from here? So that to get a perfect cube, what we need to remove from this factors? Now, if we remove this 3, if we remove this 3, we will get a perfect cube. So we have to divide this 81 by 3. Whatever remain here, we have to divide by those numbers. Okay, so we can write 81 is not a perfect cube.
If there is 2, 3, we should divide.
Yes, if there is 2 threes, you have to divide by 9, 3 into 3. Okay. It's not a perfect cube. So divide 81 by 3. We get what?
27.
81 by 3. That is 3 into 81 is 3 into 3 into 3. Divided by 3. Cancelling 3 into 3 into 3. 27, which is a perfect cube.
Ma'am, we have to write that 3 into 3 into 3. Every problem.
Or otherwise, directly you can write 27.
Okay, ma'am.
Next number, 50, same type. By which number we need to divide? 53,240. Let us start. 2. Find the factors.
Mom, can you show the question?
Asan, for doing that assignment, you have to write 2 pages, only 2 pages about the scientist Ramanujan and Hardy Ramanujan number, only that. Write about Ramanujan and Hardy Ramanujan number. Hardy number, only this. Only 2 pages is enough. First, 1 or 2 paragraph about Ramanujan. After that, what is Hardy Ramanujan number? Explain. 2 pages. Clear? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, do you get the factors? 2, 6, 6, 2, 0. Also check whether mine is correct or not. Sometimes mine also will be wrong. 2, 6, 6, 5, 5, 6, 6, 10, 10, 5. Now 11 will go. 1, 33, 3, 22. 11. So we can write 53,240 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 11 into 11 into 11. Do you get it, all of you? Agna, did you get these factors without looking the board? Alia, Alia, did you get the factors without looking the board?
Mistake is there, ma'am.
Don't do that. Simple divisions. If you have any doubt in on division in any of the numbers, you can do that in your working column. Okay, but don't make mistake. After finding each, after doing each step, check once again whether this factor is okay. By dividing this vector, the quotient is correct or not. You can check in your work, can do in the working column, but don't make mistakes. Okay, now group them. We have two triplets. Five is alone. So by which number we need to divide?
Five.
Five. So it's not a cube, perfect cube. Not a perfect cube. So divide. Divide 53,240 by 5. That is 53,240 divided by 5. That is 2 into 2 into 2. 5 into 11 into. You write these factors and divide. That is so that we can easily cancel. So the new number is 2 into 2 into 2, 8. 8 into 11 into 11 into 11. Find out which was this number.
Ma'am, 10,648.
This is equal to 10,648. In this chapter, we don't want any formula, anything. Only multiplication and division of simple numbers. So very simple. Be careful. It's a perfect cube. One more we will do, after that I'll give homeworks. One more question. 1188. All of you try this. What are the factors, Rudra? Factors are first one.
I'm still doing.
Okay, what is the first factor you did?
Mom,
I didn't hear it properly.
What is the first factor? By which number you divide first?
Two.
Then what did you get?
Ma'am. 594.
2, 5, 3, 9, 594. Again 2, 9, 7, 7.
Again
3, 3, 9, 9. Isn't it? 11. 9. No, 3. No, sorry. 9. 9, 9. 3, 11, 9. Then 3, 3, 3.
Ma'am, so, in 99, 3 will go now.
Yes.
The factors are 2 into 2 into 3, 3, sir. That we can write together. And 1, 11. Threes are appearing as triplets. So 2 twos and 1 11. So by which number we need to divide?
44.
Not eh? Perfect. 2 divided by 2 into 2 into 11, that is 44. That is divided by 44 equal to, it is better if you divide in this way by writing all the factors. We can easily divide 2 into 11, we can cancel 2s also, we can cancel 27. 3 into 3 is 27, which is a perfect cube. Is it clear, all of you? Shall I give homework questions?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear all the questions? Yeah. Okay, good. Now, so that we can move to the next stage. The homeworks are 128, 135. 128, 135, 192, fourth question, 704. These are the homework questions of this type.
Ma'am, fourth one.
704.
Ma'am, can you show the board once more?
Sure.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. All of you copied these homework questions. Shall I move to the next topic?
Yes, ma'am.
No. See, children, our time is up. You do one thing. I'm going to end the class. After that, same board, we will rejoin after 5 minutes. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.